I am here at the Morelia International Film Festival to present my film, The Lunchbox, which is actually called Amor a la Carta in Mexico. My wife is from Mexico. She's from Puebla, from Atlixco, which is a small town outside of Puebla. So yeah, Mexico is like my second home. This is the first time I'm presenting a film here. It's very exciting. In 2007, I was trying to make a documentary about the Dabbawalas, the guys who deliver the lunchboxes. And I had embedded myself with them for a couple of weeks. And during that time, I became friends with them, and they started telling me these little stories, germs of stories, you know, about the housewives they pick up lunchboxes from, like, this one takes too long because she tries something new every day, and so on and so on. And I just became more interested in those germs of stories. And then one day it just clicked, you know, that this misdelivered lunchbox would click, would like connect all these characters that have been percolating inside of me for so long. And that's how it started. The actors, it was quite a, for the character of Ila, we searched for her for a long time. She comes from theater, Nimrat Kaur. And I saw her in a play in Bombay. Really wanted someone who has like a relationship with loneliness, you know, someone who's very self-assured, but at the same time, there's something missing. Someone who we'd like to spend time with as an audience, because her whole story is in this apartment, within these four walls, and you know, she leaves twice in the film, but most of the film she's in these four walls. And for the other actors, Irfan and Nawaz, they are big stars in India, also outside of India. And when I finished the first draft of the script that I knew was working, I sort of knew that I wanted them in it. So there was one story that needed to be going on the surface, in which is the story of the script, you know. But there was another story that needed to be going on in the actors' minds, sort of another layer that they needed to be imagining what the other person looked like, what they would be when they would meet, what they would say. So it was always my goal to get the actors there. As long as I could see that there is something else going on within them and not just what's going on, you know, in the surface. And that was always there, you know. There was always there, I thought, in the performances. I felt like this was important that this be a secret. The story that's going on inside of them. And I was very conscious of trying to find it in every scene and every performance. When you make any film, you have challenges, and but you kind of have to figure out a way to make them ingrained into the fabric of the story. You have to embrace them. Bombay is a very difficult place to shoot in. Very early in the shoot, I realized that we have to embrace this chaos of Bombay. We shot in the trains. We were never a big enough production to hire a train, but we were a big enough production to hire a compartment in a train. Each time I needed more people in the frame, more extras, so to speak, I would get regular people, commuters in, and tell them, you know, you'll get a chance to meet these actors, and just stand around and don't look at the camera. It's a community of 5,000 lunchbox delivery men that deliver lunchboxes from housewives at homes to their husbands in the offices, and they deliver the empty lunchbox back in the afternoon. And it's a 125-year-old tradition. It's a profession that's passed from father to son. And most of the lunchbox delivery men used to be illiterate. So they've evolved a very complex coding system based on numbers, letters, and colors. And the statistic is that only 1 in 6 million lunchboxes is ever delivered to the wrong address. And that is the story of this, you know, this one lunchbox.